are about 100 million cases of dengue fever every year, and every one of them is transmitted by the bite of an infected mosquito, and now threatens about 100 countries and half the world's population. On a human level, it's a very painful disease with no specific treatment. On an economic level, it costs billions of dollars in affected countries from hospitalization costs, treatment. On an individual level, we can control mosquitoes easily enough, so that's another one. But we can't get enough of them that way, and we can't find the breeding sites and treat them efficiently enough for this mosquito, for the dengue mosquito, to control the disease. And if you try to do that in a city, even if you can control all the mosquitoes in your territory, if one person on your city block doesn't do that, that will produce enough mosquitoes to infect everybody. And chemicals, we would need to fill the whole environment to get the flying mosquitoes. Well, so I was looking for another way to control dengue, and I thought perhaps the best way to control all these mosquitoes would be to release more mosquitoes. I have to say, not everybody agreed with that right away, but there's a reason. So really, it's all about sex. Female mosquitoes bite, take blood, and potentially transmit disease. Males just chase the females. But what if those males were sterile? We could make them sterile by genetic engineering. Put in a gene into the males, so when it's inherited by their offspring, it stops them developing. So when we've tried this in the field, we've reduced the target mosquito populations by over 90% in every trial. And that would be enough to prevent epidemic dengue anywhere. We patented the original idea and then used that to help build a spin-out company to attract investment into the idea. The patent was essential for that. So I got the company to the point where the technology clearly works and it needs commercialization and development, but that doesn't specifically need me. So I've moved back to publicly funded research, and perhaps I'll have the next big idea.